Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you here with us and pray you will be blessed. Sit back for the next 2 hours and enjoy while we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing, pray, and read the Bible in support of one another on our journey of faith. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer request and praise reports. You may call us at 606-464-4250 anytime during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Sister Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome into our studio tonight. We have a small group of people to share with you tonight, and we know you're going to enjoy it because they're the folk from the House of Prayer up at Moorhead, and so we'll tell you more about that a little later. But we want to welcome you in, hope that this has been a good day for you. This has been an exciting day for me, and because we have another great, great grandbaby. And so that means 5 generations. That means somebody's been here for a while. And her name is Waverly May, and I do not have a picture that I can show you tonight, but I'll get around to that, don't worry. And Waverly May Galleon, and she weighed 8 pounds 5 ounces and 21 inches long, so she's going to be a tall one like her mommy and daddy. But anyway, they're doing really, really well, and so we're so thankful for that. No problems with the baby or the delivery or anything. So anyway, that was my blessing for the day. And that's she had her in Ashland at the hospital, so I don't know how long they'll have to be, but probably not too long till she can get back home and we can all see the baby. All right, we have some requests already in. Here's Christina for herself and her husband James, and from West Liberty, someone wants prayer for the Rick Dean Music, that he's having open heart surgery scheduled this week and needs and appreciates people's prayers. And here's another one from Berea, urgent prayer for a family member fell 2 weeks ago and broke his hip in 2 places and is going to the nursing home in Jackson County for rehab and wants to pray that for a full recovery and that he doesn't catch this virus. And from Isom, Patsy is not doing well. And like I say, tonight we are happy to have the House of Prayer folk, but we're really sorry that we're not going to have Jerry and Winston McClure and their son Merv. Okay. We understand Merv's in the hospital, and Brother Winston has the shingles, and Jerry is taking care of him, but we're really going to miss those three, and we want you to be praying for them. And so that's, we're going to, they've brought several with them, and it's going to be good, but then we're going to miss those, is what I'm saying, is we're going to miss them. Well, one scripture before we get started, and that is 1 Peter 5:7. And it tells us what to do that we find very hard sometimes, casting all of our care upon him, for he careth for you. And we know it's true, we know it's gospel, and we know it's for us, but sometimes we have a hard time doing that. But let's pray and ask the Lord's help. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you right now thanking you for your blessings today. We thank you for the safe and easy delivery of this grandbaby, great-great-grandbaby today. And so we ask you to continue to bless them, and Lord, the others that need help tonight, for the families and McClure's family, we ask you to touch each one of them and comfort their hearts. We know they wanted to be here, but we miss them, but Lord, you know they need the rest. And so heal them and help them, enable them to be back in church like that they need. Bless the group that's here and the phone operators. And Lord, let something be said and done tonight that will encourage people to move just a little closer to you than they have been. We know that we are all on a different pace, but Lord, we need sometimes to speed up and put forth an effort to get closer to you, and we ask you to do that for us tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we have some smiling people over here to sing for us, and I guess they're going to sing good and loud, but to make up for those that are not here. Is that the way it goes? All right, here's the House of Prayer Choir.
Tonight, and she's exactly right. We do miss Brother Winston and Sister Jerry. They're just the core of the church, you know, the foundation. And when they're missing, we miss something, you know. But honestly, we're going to move on tonight, because you know what? Maybe a small group here, but the Holy Ghost is here tonight. So we're thankful to be here. So let's get started tonight. Praise the Lord. While we are living in this world of care, many a burden that we ought to bear, but there's a prayer within the Lord's right hand. Give it a ring and he will understand. Prayer bells of heaven, oh how sweetly they ring, bearing a message unto Jesus our King. When you are burdened down with trouble,
tonight wondering what you're going to do and all these viruses trying to overtake you. My God is more than enough to supply everything you need. Just lean on Him and do His commandments and obey Him. If you don't know Him, this is a great time to get to know Him, because He's always there for you. All you got to do is reach out and take it.
My God, He's more than enough.
Help us across. Just listen to the words of this song.
The road's been long, I'm a little bit weary, a lot of miles behind me, they won't start nearer. I got one more crossing, it's a long way over. Won't you stand by the river, wait for this old body can't take it long, and I can't wait till I make it home. So stand by the river, wait for me. Won't you stand by the river, Lord, and hold my trembling hand? Pray to me, sweet Jesus, from the cold, dark, sinking sand. Well, this old body can't take it long, and I can't wait till I make it home. So. Thank you.
Another mile, just one more mile. I'm tired of walking all alone. Lord, help me smile, just one more smile, just one more smile. I know I just can't make it on my own. Never thought I'd needed help before. I thought that I could do things by myself. Now I know that I just can't take it anymore. With a humble heart on bended knee, I'm begging you, please help me. Come down from your golden throne to me. Feel the touch of your hand. Remove the chains of darkness. Let me see, Lord, please let me see just where I fit into your master plan. Never thought I needed help before. I thought that I could do things by myself. Now I know I just can't take it anymore. With a humble heart on bended knee, I'm begging you, please help me. With a humble heart on bended knee, I'm begging you, please help me.
Praise the Lord. What a song. Help me, Lord. Help me. I talked to Sister Jerry earlier today, and she said, now, there's a preacher in Lewis County by the name of Jackie Thomas. Send a song out to him today. So, Jackie, this is for you. Keep on that fire in line. Amen?
Praise the Lord.
If you're in the battle for the Lord and right, keep on that fire in line. Now, if you win, my brother, surely you must fight. Keep on that. In the soul, he will find.
thing a winner either way.
Yeah.
It don't matter whether health takes us down here, we're a winner, because if we've got our way made for us, we already know Jesus Christ and Him crucified and risen again, we're going to go home. You know, or if He just comes and takes us out, we're still a winner. So listen to the words of this song.
A loved one knew it reached the end of life's journey, but he'd been holding to God's hand a long, long time. As I knelt beside his bed, my heart was thrilled at what he had said. If I go or if I stay, the victory.
Thank you for all those songs. They're going to take a little break, and they'll be back with some more good ones. We appreciate the group that has come to sing for us tonight. We miss all of them, but you know, we're trying to obey the laws of our land and just keep just a few as is allowed, of course, to be together. But we have Miss Robin. She has come over to visit with us and tell us about the church and everything, and we miss your husband tonight.
Amen.
Is he working?
Yeah, they've all left me. They're all gone.
Well, we'll have a pity party after a service.
That's right, yeah.
Okay, tell us how's things going at the House of Prayer.
Well, it's going wonderful at the House of Prayer. You know, everybody kind of getting back from the pandemic, from being away so long. And sometimes there's still a little caution going on. People just still a little reserved yet. And we do have online services, and we have in-person services, and it's very safe. And we just come back together in love a little at a time. So we have gone back to our Sunday morning, Sunday night, and Wednesday night services. Okay. In fact, this coming Sunday, we have Terry Tripp coming. He'll be here at a.m. and p.m. service. He's a wonderful speaker. He has his book. It's called, like, Shut the Hell Up. But he means shut the hell, as in not heaven, but hell. Shut it up, you know, close it down. Don't listen to what the enemy has to say to you. So he's been there for several years. He pops in, and we really enjoy his preaching. So he'll be there this coming Sunday morning and Sunday night, 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. So that's something that somebody might want to pop in if you're near our area.
Okay, but and you're still using the mask?
Yes. We do. Right now we're using masks as we enter into our church. Mm-hmm. And while you're wandering around and talking and, you know, just visiting, fellowshipping with one another. But when we sit down, we're usually always 6 foot apart, and then we take it off, and then we enjoy our service. Okay. And someone told me the other day, they said it's like M&M. So when you move, put on the mask. M&M, move the mask. Oh, so while we're sitting there and we're 6 foot apart and we're just enjoying, now this guy at our church, he wants to put M&Ms in the mask. I don't know about that. Yeah, I do. I think it's great. That's a really good idea. M&Ms in the mask. But we're doing our very best to be safe and for you to feel at home and comfortable. You have to let the Spirit of the Lord into the church. You've got to let it take liberty. And so we are very happy at the church. And like I said, getting back to our numbers and people coming in, and it's really doing good. We're expecting to go into homecoming, Lord willing, if everything goes well, and just seeing how things are going, how people are doing. So we're hoping the second week in August, the Lohr family will be there at 11 o'clock in the morning. And Lord willing, won't say for definite, we're going to try to have homecoming. It's like our 48th year.
Oh, my.
Gosh, yeah, that's a long time.
Yes, well, that's something to look forward to. Well, what about, bring us up to date on Jerry and Winston's physical condition.
Well, she thought maybe a couple of weeks ago we would had service at a pavilion outside. Mm-hmm. Well, she thought maybe he got ate up with a bunch of mosquitoes at first. He got, there's just something wrong. He's ate up and didn't realize that he had shingles. Ouch. And so she is like the world's best doctor living with you. So she's really doctored him up and kept him going. But some of the medicines they put you on is worse than having the what you got. So it's really been kind of hard on him. But he's doing well. You know, Brother Winston never misses a service. And to miss this, it's a big deal. But now I'm on the big screen at his house. So that's a big deal. So at least they're here with us tonight, and that is great.
Yes.
Sister Jerry's just a trooper, you know. She's just a jack of all trades. Mm-hmm. There's nothing she can't do or nothing she won't do to help you out in your time of need. Mm-hmm. And we've said already, their son Merv, he just come down not feeling well on a Wednesday night. And next thing you know, the next day, he's been to the doctor, and he's had emergency surgery. But bless God, he's doing wonderful. He's on the mend. He's healing. Let me tell you this one. It's a good one. So his wife, Lucia, is at the doctor with him one day. Excuse me, at the hospital. Mm-hmm. She said, Merv, what do you want me to do? You want me to hang around with you? You want me to stay? What you want me to do, Merv? He says, well, if you leave, I'd take a nap. So she said, okay. So he was just relaxing and just trying to get better. Sometimes there's nothing you can do but just sit through it. So he's about tired of resting and wants to come home, but I think they said the doctor is probably in a couple of days, maybe he'll be ready.
Okay. All right. Well, that sounds good, encouraging. Mm-hmm. And we do miss him, though, tonight.
Exactly. We sure do. Yes.
So you're still back to the services and so forth. Yes. And the phone number, if someone wants more information about your guests, is this the one to call?
Yes. Exactly.
Okay, you want to give it?
Yeah, 606-784-7023. That's Winston Jerry's number, and they take care of all that.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a full-time.
It is.
A full-time job.
It is.
Sometimes you just, around here, we just wish for somebody to just take care of
the... Answer the phone.
Yes. But, well, that is so good to have everybody, and missing those that...
Absolutely.
Are not here, but you know, this is kind of the way life is, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It is.
That, I mean, nothing stays the same.
No, and you can never go back.
No.
You got to move forward.
Yes, yes, that's, yes, we, well, with this, you know, new new addition to our family today. Yeah. And then see, it was only 2 years ago that I lost my daughter. And yeah. I noticed one of the ladies singing, she recently lost her daughter, didn't she?
She has, yes.
And okay. So, you know, we come and go. And on some days, I'm really glad the Lord didn't say we got to stay as long as Methuselah did, because it gets yes. a little weary sometimes mm-hmm. with so much going on. And how we want to see people start being kinder and yes. and just have good principles about them.
They, yeah, common sense.
Yeah, yeah, just common sense. Treat each one like they should. And instead of finding something to fuss about, mm-hmm. you can always do that.
Oh, amen.
And that's not going to get you any place except in turmoil and put mm-hmm. everybody else around you.
Exactly.
And kind of rob their peace too. But you know, you look and know what all we're going through, but then to look a little ahead, we know that we're going to see Jesus.
That's right. It's going to be worth it after all.
Yes, it's going to.
Exactly.
Here's a elderly man from Floyd County, Herbert, has called and said that when I gave my great-grandbaby's a name, said it was almost like his late wife's name.
Oh, so, how sweet.
So that maybe blessed him.
That's right.
But we have, we want to do what we can for the Lord now, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, exactly.
So what's been on your heart you'd like to share tonight?
I've been thinking about Job lately.
Oh.
I've been thinking about Job's friends. I've been thinking about, we have a lot of opinions surfacing now. Everybody has got an opinion, mm-hmm. and everybody's got advice for you that they think you need to take because I know what's best for you. And I got to name of Job's friends, and they all come to Job, and basically they said, Job, okay, tell me, what'd you do wrong? Because mm-hmm. if anything goes wrong in your life, it's because you did something wrong, right? Mm-hmm. Wrong. They, you know, it was Job. Things happened to him, and the friends kind of said almost like, you know, what'd you do wrong? Did you sleep with the secretary? Did you take from the register? What'd you do wrong for all this mm-hmm. to happen in your life? And I thought, you know, that was just the wrong way to look at it. And I thought, you know, Job looked at his friends one day. He said, you all are miserable friends. You're just bad friends. So who do you take advice from? Whose opinion do you take? Reminds me of a story at the beauty shop. There's this lady that come into the beauty shop one day and got her hair done. Well, her and the hairdresser talked over what kind of hair color that she was going to have. And they did the color, and it was wonderful. And she walked out happy as she can be. This color was perfect for the summer. It would last long, save her money, and have a great time. A couple hours later, the lady calls back. I don't like my hair anymore. She says, but you just loved it 3 hours ago. Well, what happened? Well, I was out and about, and I ran into my sister. My sister had a friend with her, and the friend said she didn't like it. She didn't think it covered well. Her friend just thought it wasn't a good color. Okay, come on back into the salon. So she came back in the salon, they looked at the hair, and honestly, it was exactly great like it was the day before she left. But I can tell you what I can do. We'll do it the way your sister's friend, a woman you barely know, wants to do it. We'll do it that way. Let's see. It's going to cost you more money. You'll have to come in more often. It's not as natural looking, but hey, take the opinion of that woman. Go right ahead. So easy to take someone's opinion that you don't even know who they are. They don't know who you are.
Mm-mm.
But I'm reminded, John chapter 13, Jesus is in Jerusalem. Within hours, he'd be given his life for hours mm-hmm. on the cross. But in an upper room with his 12 disciples, he come across and he got his towel and he began to wash their feet. And Peter said, oh no, Lord, you can't wash my feet. He said, Peter, if I don't wash your feet, you ain't got nothing in me. Well, then go ahead, wash my feet, wash my hands, wash all over me, he said. So every year, December 31st at the House of Prayer, about 8 o'clock in that night, we all gather around the fellowship hall for our Last Supper, because that's my Last Supper every year, because January the 1st, I start a new diet every year. It's my Last Supper, I call it. So we have this supper that night, and the men will go into the church, and the ladies will stay in the fellowship hall, and we start turning the chairs one toward another. One lady goes and gets a basin full of nice warm water while another gets a towel. And I begin to talk about John chapter 13. And those ladies, like, almost bow, bend down before one another, and they wash their feet. And they cry. And they speak over that woman's family and her children, her health, her finances. And the one getting her feet washed begins to raise her hands and praise the Lord as we sing, like, how great thou art, and oh, Jesus loves me. She takes her hand, she places it over the woman who's washing her feet and begins to pray over her. That's who I'll take advice from. That's whose opinion I value. Someone who would wash my feet. Someone would take the time and pray for my family. At the beginning of a new year, that woman, I think I can trust. Someone you don't know gives you advice and their opinion on your life. If they're not willing to wash your feet, I'm not willing to take their advice. Their opinion doesn't mean too much to me at all. Yeah. Job looked at his friends that day and said, you are lousy friends. You're miserable friends. That's not the friends that I want tonight. I want those who will stand closer to me than a brother. I want, Francie said it earlier tonight. She said, you know, we need to be hanging on to the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit of God that lives inside of us. I mean, we need to be in His lap. We need to be on His back. We need to be holding on to His hand. And whenever He opens the curtain and shows us the vision, let's run for it. We need the Word of God in our life more than we've ever needed the Word of God in our life. So if we'll hold on to the Holy Spirit, our guide home, and we'll get in God's Word that will teach us the right way to act and how to treat people, we'll see Him come back. We will see His face one day. And so that's my thought. It's been the last couple of weeks. I want good friends, not miserable friends. But Job, being a good man, prayed for his friends and got back double of all that he had before. So pray for those who give you bad advice. Pray for those whose opinions you don't need in your life. That's on my mind tonight. Those women that night that washed my feet, they take off their socks and their boots and it's cold, you know, it's winter time. But they began to sing and they began to pray over me. Their voice is worthy in my life because they have the voice of God in their heart. So just at this time, this day we're in, be cautious who you let speak into your life. Take heed to those who speak over you, who give you their opinion, what they think you ought to do. Seek God and seek those who love God for good advice.
Amen. That is so good. That is so good. So that's the kind of people that you do need in your life. We all do. We all do, because we've all met with the other kinds, so we
wrong path.
Yes. And you know, showing humility and really, really, you know, one scripture says not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think. And so, if that definitely would be a test, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
And if. Because pride is real easy to slip in, and you think that, oh, well, I don't really need to do that.
I'm a little better than the other.
Yeah.
That's right. It's, no. You're right.
That is wonderful. Yeah. And so you say you have this gathering every...
So called like our watch night service, and we all just gather in. Because you know what? For years and years, we've been gathering to pray in the new year. There's just something humbling about being on your knees, watching one year come out, and praying the new year in. You know, it's always one of those, it's great to, Lord, just to forgive me if I've thought anything. Maybe I said something, or if I'd done something throughout the year, whether I knew it or whether I didn't. You know, we can make mistakes and not even know it was a mistake. Have you ever like had a conversation, but an hour later, something that you said comes back to maybe a tone in your voice, or you seemed a little smart aleck or rude or rushed, and what do? You quickly, you know, the Holy Spirit has convicted you, and you call that person, I am so sorry, I didn't mean to say it that way. And they're saying, honey, I didn't even get what you said. You know, they don't even notice it, but I'm glad that we repent when those things come to our heart. We want to be clean. It's like, I don't want nothing be between me and the Lord. There are no stopping up, no clogged arteries, you know. Let nothing be clogged, nothing be stopped, that I can't feel the presence of God.
Yes, Lord.
And receive the blessings that He has for us. In this time, in this day, we need Him more than ever.
Oh, yes, yes.
So we need to repent quickly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Because if you don't, then it allows a lot of things to start growing.
Yes, it does.
And unforgiveness is kind of hard to deal with, and the longer you pay attention to a offense that you have, the more that you become involved in it, and you unforgiveness and bitterness and anger
and you let it overwhelm you, and the person that you're mad at doesn't even know you're mad at them.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not bothered at all, you know? So you're the one eating it up. So it is good. That hit home. but that is right, though. Sometimes we just got to forgive and try to move on.
Yeah, you better pray for me tonight. Well, do you think they have some more songs?
Absolutely, we have some more songs tonight.
Well, let's have some more, because the music is always good.
It is so good.
And we appreciate them.
And we do miss everyone that's not here. I mean, it's just, we're trying to be respectful to guidelines and to show our light in a dark world. Rebellion and defiance is not a good thing.
No.
Not right now. We need to be a light.
Yes, yeah. Well, all right, then we'll release you to go back to to help them, or were you going to help them?
Oh, yeah, I was going to help.
Or you were going to make them do it all on their own? We have a large amount of requests already in, too,
yes.
So we'll take care of those a little later. But right now, we're going to go back to the House of Prayer Choir, and we appreciate all of their good songs and how faithful, you know. Faithful, being faithful. That speaks volumes when we're faithful to the Lord. All right, let's go for some more good music.
The king set a feast for a banquet. He invited all his men to come and play. But he didn't know before the night was over that the kingdom that he held would pass away. As the crowd began to roar in a drunken slumber, a worried look soon took his smile away. And as he looked, he said, "Behold, I see a finger, and it's writing something on the wall today.
Tells a story again.
so true. The world's getting closer to destruction. As you walk the streets, you'll hear the words doomsday. Now we all know something's soon to happen, because the wicked men refuse to stop and pray. But soon their laughter will one day turn to mourning, and the cries for help will be heard far away. But like the king, when he finally saw the message, it's then he had realized he'd waited too late. Well, the handwriting's on the wall, can't you see it? Now the message tells the story.
Thank you so much for that. And if Robin will come back, we'll take care of the prayer requests. So we're going to run out of time if we don't do it right now. But we appreciate all the good songs. And so she can go through these in a hurry, and we will.
Okay. Praise the Lord. We have Michelle Perry here tonight. That she has, her husband has a hip problem, and Joanne has a bladder problem tonight. Pamela Russell has prayed for her Aunt Loretta and prayed for also her sister. And Tanya and Troy has a grandbaby called in by Louise. 1 month baby can't eat and is still in the hospital. So let's remember that baby, speaking of babies being so precious and everything. Iona, I believe it is, prays for Geneva. She's in UK hospital. Tanya from Campbell County prays for in kidney failure, and she needs our prayers. We pray for you tonight, Tanya. Pray for sister having kidney problems also. Pray for JR and Debbie Rose, all their children and their grandchildren tonight. Pray for Judy and Arnold Moore at their UK and ICU. In ICU, they have COVID-19. Let's pray for them, be above and beyond healthy and well. Mm-hmm. Over in Bath County, pray for Donna. She's in Winchester Hospital. She has cellulitis, and pray for the family and her friends. Also in Pulaski County, says pray for him, which is Carl. He's been sick for 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. Nobody wants to be sick, do they? Mm-mm. No. For Boyd Cochran, called in by his sister from Casey County, he has cancer tonight. Let's remember that in our prayers. A mother wants to pray for her son because her son is sick tonight. Just a lot of people are sick, granddaughters, special needs, just needing our prayer tonight. Oh, this is a good one. Pray for the unemployment benefits to come through.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
I think my last day I worked was March the 18th, and I got my benefits yesterday. So it took that long. So sometimes it takes a long time to get it. The right person, the right time, the right email. So I know what you mean. I'll pray for you personally because it's a big deal. Mm-hmm. Somebody's knees are hurting tonight. 14-year-old grandbaby just don't get to see the baby, would like to see the baby more. Somebody has an unspoken request tonight. Pray for Mark and Rhonda tonight. Someone wants to pray for their neighbors tonight. That's a great one to pray for. Mm-hmm. Pray for our family tonight. So that's all I have. Just a lot of prayers tonight. Everybody just, we all have something to pray for. Amen. There's just something going on in all of our lives. And to pray for a mother and a grandmother in our prayers. Someone's in the nursing home and is septic right now. We definitely want to pray for that. Another friend has cancer, wants cancer to be prayed for. Thelma just needs to be prayed for in Madison County. Also in Breathitt County, people are want prayed for also. Cancer again, so sad. Mm-hmm. Salvation, people mm-hmm. want their family members to be saved. It's the biggest deal. Yes. Hospital, infections here. The battle's not mine. They like that song, and no one does it better than Lucy Day. And so she's not here, and we ran out of time, but it's also an amazing song. They just enjoyed our program tonight. So thank you all that tuned in and have enjoyed the program tonight. That's a big deal.
We'll put these together.
I agree.
There's the oil and
absolutely.
So the requests have been made.
Yes.
And so we're going to ask now for help. And then our next step is to start expecting it.
Exactly.
And so go ahead and lead
Praise
us,
the
would
Lord.
You?
So, yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you and we ask you in Jesus' name to each and every prayer request, make yourself known. God, that you are the healer of our bodies. You're the deliverer in our time of need. God, I know that you want us to prosper and be in health even as our soul prospers, because that's in your word, Father.
Yes.
So tonight, from the seat of victory, I thank you and praise you for meeting every need. We just expect, as Sister Margaret says, to hear great praise reports for people to say, hey, guess what? Guess what? The testimonies that this is a light that brightens up the darkness right now. So God, forever we thank you and we praise you for meeting every need at your will in your time, in Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the
Lord. All right.
Amen.
Well, we appreciate the Lord's presence with us tonight.
That's
and
right.
We have missed the mama and papa.
That's right. Exactly.
Because they're Jerry and Winston. We really miss them, we always look forward to them. They can make anybody feel like they're that you're their kid or something, and so that's quite a knack right there be able to make people feel that love and appreciated.
Amen.
And we do appreciate this church so much. This is one church that when we get to go visit, which we don't anymore, but anyway, we've always felt very welcome and had good services, and it's just a place that, you know, you can actually feel at ease and be able to enjoy the service. All right, is there anything else, Robin, you need to tell the people about your church or about to look out for?
Just a reminder, again, this coming Sunday morning, Terry Tripp will be there Sunday morning and Sunday night. You can hop on a live stream, YouTube, anywhere and check him out, you know, and see. So if you don't live stream, just go to House of Prayer on House of Prayer Incorporated on Facebook. Find us and hop in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. Now that is Laverne Tripp's.
Yes, exactly.
We'll see over the years. We have played tons of their tapes
there
on the radio, and so it's Laverne Tripp's son, isn't it?
Yes.
So that would be good,
it
be interesting. And well, looks like we are just out of time again. But appreciate all the songs and the effort that this group has taken time out from their work today to come and there's more requests just came down. But let's see if it's something that we can share, maybe a salvation report, which what we hope, but we'll hope that it is. But anyway, we appreciate you staying with us, and you know, we've had to make a lot of adjustments around here. We did not have our spring telethon, and we've just been trusting the Lord to meet the needs. And let's see, this is this is for Uncle Frank that David has called in. Liver cancer, 6 months to live.
Oh.
All right, we'll be praying for him as we are out of time. So from all of us, good night. And God bless you.
Good night.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest program. We trust you are blessed every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution of support. Will you become a financial partner of Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? We invite you to send your pledges of support to WLJC, Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.wljc.com. May God bless you.